Blackstone presents Ashes by Ari Marmell. This book is read by Cindy Kay. Content warning, CW. Violence, graphic injury, body horror, drug use, prolonged illness, suicide, dead animals, dead infants, pedo, hebephilia, though anything explicit remains off-screen, gaslighting and manipulation, slurs and bigotry, catcalling. Chapter 1. They sat around a table in a high-backed booth, tucked away in the corner of the Starport Cafe. Her hands were warming around a steaming mug of black coffee. Cynthia stared at the glass panels that formed the front wall, peering through her phantasmal reflection at the bare-branched trees beyond. She looked deader than they did. Pale, shrunken, bloodless. Almost as dead as... No, stop it! A few sporadic images were all she'd retained of the moments following their soul-shattering discovery. Natsuhiko doubled over the hood of an abandoned car, vomiting and weeping. Johanna's screams fading into unending moans, a wordless and primal pain. And Grigori. Grigori, lips pressed tight, grim but determined, lifting, cajoling, dragging them back to the charger, jabbing Cynthia with a syringe of Dilaudid, slipping behind the wheel, driving as fast as he dared to the main gate of the Johnson campus, ushering them inside, gathering coffee from behind the cafeteria counter, and retrieving several bottles of stronger stuff from the trunk of the car. If not for him, they might still be out on the highway, mesmerized by the incomprehensible carnage and gradually losing their minds. Now he hovered over them, half drill sergeant, half mother hen.
I wish you would try to eat something.
Natsuhiko thumped a finger against the bottle of Jim Bean.
This'll do.
Cynthia directed a pointed glance at a trash can across the cafeteria. One everyone but Grigori had visited at least once since they'd arrived. I'm barely keeping down the coffee right now. I don't think I'll be eating again this year. From Joe, they heard nothing. She'd said nothing, done nothing, drunk nothing since Grigori guided her to the booth. Cynthia wasn't entirely sure the woman had even blinked. If she'd had the emotional strength to worry, that would have worried her. Cynthia had never seen the Starport Cafe empty before. It felt sad. The booths, the tables, the glass, the vaguely retro-future rounded light fixtures, the tiled floor. Nothing particularly wrong with any of them, but taken as a whole, without the buzz of conversation and the clatter of cutlery and the sense of cooking, it all proved sterile, soulless. The people who had once gathered here to eat, to socialize, to take a few minutes for themselves, had included countless NASA personnel, the builders of what was supposed to be the future. It should have been special. But then, look at the future we got. Chiding herself, Cynthia turned her attention back to the windows, to her reflection. Only, it wasn't hers anymore.
God, not again!
Again. Again. As she had so many times since they'd gotten here, she saw not herself, but her mother. Not the trees and grass of the lawn outside, but the sandy California beaches she'd visited so often as a child. And again, as clearly as if cast by a movie projector, she saw her mother, face aglow with a beatific smile, eagerly stroll over to the water's edge, to it, and then into it, the waves lapping up to her knees, her waist, her chest, until she was gone. She never even liked to swim. Is that what had happened? Had her mother, had everyone, done as the countless dead of Clear Lake? Done as the profane lettering on those obelisks? Come not merely from space, Cynthia felt now, but from hell, demanded? She couldn't know, not for certain. But she had no reason to doubt. Nor could she tell anymore if the constant repetition of that image, sometimes her mother alone, sometimes with friends or family, but always with the same outcome, was just her distraught imagination running out of control or genuine hallucination, overwhelming grief, or a symptom of her worsening condition. And God help her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.